This Moosecast is brought to you by Broken Cherry, boutique, design studio, and custom apparel. For the coolest in Derby Girl merchandise, go to shop.brokencherry.com, where the Derby family always gets a 10% discount. Just use the Derby Rocks discount code at checkout and tell them Moose sent ya.
Hi, this is Chip Queso in care of Derby News Network here at the Western Regionals. I'm standing here with she who cannot be named from Rocky Mountain, victorious over the Houston, host of the Western Regionals, 141-116. She who cannot be named played a very tough game.
Yes.
You had a three-jammer rotation, I believe. What was your strategy going into this to make it to the second round?
Well, we just decided that we're going to keep doing what we know best, which is heavy defense. I mean, we have been working on our offense as of late. And, you know, we are known for that two-jammer rotation. And, you know we can do it. We have good endurance. And we have met Houston briefly before earlier in the year. It was more of a organized scrimmage. It wasn't a full-on bout. So we were kind of familiar with our opponents, but we know that things change. And, you know, 6 months in Derby is an eternity. So we just kind of came in here and focused on our game and did what we needed to do to win.
Absolutely, it was back and forth in the beginning, and then you pulled out and kept that lead. Houston came back with some momentum changes, but you stuck to your guns. You started playing jammers as blockers in that rotation, especially Frida Beater.
Yes.
And that was a strategy that just kept you to stay ahead. Is that correct?
Yes, it was part of our strategy. Like I said before, we did stick with our two jammer rotation. You know, the one thing that continues to kill us is penalties, and maybe I'm giving something away here, but it's pretty obvious to everyone watching that we were in the box a lot. But luckily, you know, Houston didn't capitalize on it as much to win the game, so we got really, really lucky. They played a hard game, and they're gracious hosts. We love them dearly, and, you know, it was fun, and we thank them very much for having us here.
Well, it was a hard-fought bout, and I think you better go home and soak your wounds because you get the advantage of playing the Texecutioners tomorrow, who you have not faced, and they were watching, so it should be an interesting bout coming with full force, but we're excited to see it. Anything looking towards that bout?
Well, we're excited to play it. We've being that they were the mothers of Flat Track Derby, we're extremely honored to play them. And we know they have some veterans, but they also have some newcomers that we're kind of familiar with. So we're hoping that we can at least just hang in there and give them a tough game and at least come out with our pride intact. So,
well, there you go. Good luck. She who could not be named, Chip Queso for Derby News Network. Stay tuned. More good flat track action.
Hi, this is the Mangler, Mario Martinez, live in Houston, Texas, at the Western Regionals Roller Derby Tournament here with the Houston Hard Knocks captain, the hometown girl, the lovely, the beautiful, the deadly Penny Raider. How'd it go out there today?
It went great. I'm really proud of our team. We scrimmaged Rocky Mountain several months ago, and we learned so much from them. They were so nice, and we were floored by their play, and we've really been putting stuff into practice to be ready to try to move ourselves up in the rankings. And we played as a team, and I'm proud. I can't believe we went from an 80 point disparity to as close as we could do it this time. And it was a fun game. We really liked those girls.
Oh, definitely during the first half, it was a back-and-forth battle. They definitely gained some momentum on you in the second half. I'm very proud of the way Houston represented, the way you've hosted the whole thing, the whole event, and the heart that was shown by the Hard Knocks team. Very happy, very proud of everything that you've pulled off today.
Yeah, thank you very much. We love having everybody. This was like a dream come true for our nascent league. And I don't know. We're happy, and the good news is even with the loss, we get to play again in about 2 hours. So win-win.
That's definitely a good thing for you guys. I have a lot of pity in my heart for whoever you're facing next, but I also look forward to seeing you girls shine one more time today.
Okay, me too. Thank you very much.
All right, for the Derby News Network, this is the Mangler, Mario Martino, signing out.
I'm Dump Truck, here with Kamikaze Kim, team captain from Enseques Muertos out of Albuquerque, New Mexico, representing Duke City. Kamikaze Kim, how did you feel about the earlier bout today? We're going to talk about the one that just happened here in a minute, but the earlier bout today, how did you feel about it going in? What did you really tell your team? What was going on?
I'm sorry, the Pikes Peak Bout? I'm sorry.
Yes, it would be the Pikes Peak. Oh, it's all good. It's been a long day. Pikes Peak Bout, what was your feelings going into that?
Okay. Well, you know, they're a great team. We've known them for many years, and we highly respect them. They're a great team. They've come a long way, and when a team comes back from a year before where they were, I think, 1-6 to be almost undefeated this season, you know, you have to take notice and really pay attention. And so we didn't take them lightly whatsoever.
And that obviously worked in your favor. They obviously, we're about to talk about what just happened. They beat Pikes Peak earlier today here in Houston at the 2008 WFTDA Western Regionals at the Verizon Theater. And you had a jam that was very significant because you set a WFTDA record. Could you tell me about that a little bit?
Well, I wasn't jamming to set the record. I just was skating fast and trying to score a lot of points.
How many points did you score and how did you do it?
I hear 25. I don't remember. But I remember my blockers doing a really amazing job controlling the pack. And that was, I think, really the key for me to get all those points. I just remember going, just circling. And my blockers are there, and they deserve a lot of the credit, too. Yeah.
The entire team deserves a lot of credit. She got 25 points in one jam. It was 5 grand slams in a row. Never been done before. Okay, something just happened. A lot of you, if you're watching or listening or MySpacing or whatever live right now, you already know what the final score is. You just finished bouting Kansas City Roller Warriors. I believe they're out of Kansas City. It's a toss-up. They were number one. Y'all were number 17. What happened in your mind on your way into this bout?
Well, I told my team that, you know, we got over the first game and take every game one at a time, and that we had nothing to lose in this game and to leave everything on the track.
Leave it on the track is very good advice. How did everything end up at the end of that bout?
Well, I guess I have to book a ticket to Portland now.
If you didn't know, then we're not friends anymore. The Duke City girls beat Kansas City Roller Warriors. I mean, it came down to the wire. They are now going to Nationals. They bumped out the number one seed. Last year's national champions are no longer going to Portland. It is now Albuquerque's turn to shine. Mensekis Muercos making a stamp on life, making a difference. And yes, it is anyone's game. I'm Dump Truck. This is Kamikaze Cam. Thank you for watching the Derby News Network.